This Linux malware goes stealth mode, QNAP patches a zero day, and Mandiant is acquired by Google. All that coming up now on ThreatWire. Greetings, I am Shannon Morse and this is ThreatWire for September 13th, 2022. This is your summary of the threats to our security, privacy, and internet freedom. Let's go ahead and jump right into the news this week. Security researchers at AT&T's Alien Labs have discovered and analyzed new malware that's targeting Linux devices. Now, both traditional servers that run Linux distros, as well as IoT smart home devices, are being attacked. This new strain of malware differs from others due to its sophistication and its ability to be very stealth, while also being used to install a crypto miner. This malware uses legit cloud services for hosting of the attacker's CNC servers, as well as polymorphic encoding to evade detection. This is due to its use of a Metasploit module, which is called Shikata Ganai, which encodes shellcode. This malware is dubbed Shikitega, and it's currently unknown how the initial infection happens. Shikitega evades detection by downloading the malware bit by bit in what is called a multi-stage infection chain. So each and every single piece of a new payload receives commands from the previous part of the payload and creates a chain reaction of downloading and executing the malware. The researchers noted that Shikitega starts with just a very small initial dropper, then downloads the Metasploit tool, which is called Metal, to control IoT devices. After this, it continues on to run shell commands and download additional modules to get persistence on an infected machine. The final payload gives the attacker full root privileges, and it downloads that crypto miner. Now, Shikitega uses known vulnerabilities in Linux, including CVE-2021-3493, which is a validation issue in the Linux kernel, and CVE-2021-4034, which is a memory corruption vulnerability, which is called Pwnkit. Both of those flaws allow for Shikitega to work, so the researchers recommend applying patches for both of those and updating as soon as updates are available. They have also listed the IOCs, or the indicators of compromise, in their analysis for admins to use. It is a new week with a new QNAP zero day. Yay! QNAP posted a security bulletin for users to immediately update Photo Station to the latest available version due to a zero day being used by Deadbolt ransomware. Now, they noticed an uptick in ransomware attacks last Saturday that were targeting NAS devices connected directly to the internet with widespread use. A patch was made available within 12 hours of detecting those attacks and assessing this vulnerability. QNAP also offered an alternative, which is called QMAGI, which is a photo storage management tool that can replace Photo Station on NAS products. QNAP has not disclosed any of the technical details about this zero day that was discovered, but you can read their security bulletin. Now, Deadbolt is not new. The ransomware has been in use since January, encrypting files on vulnerable NAS devices with a DOT Deadbolt extension and hijacking the regular login page with a ransom note. But now it's just using a new vector for the attack. The patch, which varies in version number depending on the QTS version that you are running on your NAS device, can prevent Deadbolt ransomware from using the Photo Station zero day. But if you have a NAS connected to the internet, please consider removing it from the internet. These can be placed behind firewalls, and users can try using MyQNAP Cloud instead. QNAP also recommends using a strong password for user accounts, disabling port forwarding on routers, upgrading your firmware, and of course, creating backups often. Biggest of shout outs to my Hush Puppy Perk level patrons for sharing their fur baby photos and of course for the support. And a huge thank you to my newest patron, Jack L, for joining the Alliance over at patreon.com/threatwire. Thank you so much, Jack, for joining. I hope you enjoy all of the perks that come with your Alliance membership. My YouTube channel is youtube.com/Shannon Morse for everything from tech reviews to security tutorials. And remember to subscribe to this channel as well. Hack 5 is great. growing every single day, and it's always exciting to have you here. Let's go ahead and finish out today's episode with my last top story, which is all about Mandiant and Google. Way back in March, Google announced that they were planning to buy Mandiant, which is a huge cybersecurity company, for $5.4 billion. The acquisition means that they would buy the company for $23 per share, all cash, and Mandiant would become a part of Google Cloud. They finally closed the deal yesterday, September 12th, for the full disclosed amount. Now, Google posted a blog about this purchase, saying that this will allow them to grow cloud security. Mandiant is joining Google Cloud to increase security for organizations and improve their threat, incident, and exposure management. Google is using this acquisition to expand the current Google Cloud security portfolio that they offer by adding more to the suite of enterprise security offerings, along with pioneering new approaches with Google's use of data processing, AI, and machine learning. Google has also mentioned that Mandiant's threat research will continue to be shared to help support organizations, including those that do not run on Google Cloud. The Mandiant brand will also remain unchanged. So this is definitely a positive change for Google Cloud users, since Mandiant is at the forefront of cybersecurity. But I am very curious what you think of this acquisition. Comment below and let me know your thoughts. I'm Shannon Morse, and I will see you next time on the internet.